It's an evening head shade, and we're using Italian citrus shave soap from Fine Accoutrements. It's in their 21st century soap base, so we're expecting a rich, creamy, yogurty lather. And that's coming up next. Hi, YouTubers and wet shavers everywhere. It's FarmerGeorgeTune.com. I'm back with another video. Great to see you again. Thanks so much for stopping by and sharing your time with me. Really do appreciate it. Let's get right to it. We've got my Paul Gruner shaving bowl. Thanks again to Jimmy V. We're going to take that hot water and dump it out. We've got Italian citrus shave soap. I got some hot water in it there, right there like that. Got some hot water in it right there like that. That's what I meant to say. And we have got my Timeless Razor adjustable shave brush handle with a 28 millimeter shaving knot, synthetic shaving knot from Magrid Razor. Thanks again to Alex Lopez for sending that along. And we are going to go ahead and load this brush and do a quick bowl lather here. You can see I've got the pre-shave on my head already. And this is a mild scent, a mild citrus scent. I'm not getting a citrus forward kind of scent from it. It's a little more refined, it's a little more subtle, it's a little more understated, to be perfectly honest with you. It is nice. It is not going to overwhelm. That's for certain. It won't get in the way with any other aftershave or cologne that you want to use. If you want to use something like a Limoncello aftershave, which I have here, or a Nordost Orange aftershave, which I also have, those will be definitely be more bold in scent than this. This is really subtle. It's a nice scent, but it is really, really subtle. That's enough on the brush right there, I believe. And here is my lathering bowl. I got a little bit of water in there, so we're going to go ahead and build a lather. This is their Fine Accoutrements 21st Century Soap Base, which is a very, very good soap base. And you can see, again, I've got that pre-shave on there. So we're doing an evening head shave. I'm going to be using my Supply SE Single Edge Injector Razor. I've got a new blade in there, so it's ready to go. So, and it just, you know, injector razor, it was zip, zip, in and out. It was amazing. Just a really amazing. Check out my original view of the Supply SE to see how quickly that blade changes out. It's really, really nice. Okay, so look at this. Look at this already. This is a great soap base. I'm going to give it a little more water, just a little more, just a little more, just to get a little more lather. That's what I'm thinking is happening here. Look at that. Look how much I have there. Okay, look at how nice that. Boom, lather. Check that out. That is really, really nice. I'm going to put a little bit of water on my head. Hang on a minute. I just want to wet that down a little bit. That's the pre-shave soap from the Cube 2.0. I'm going to put a little more on there so it doesn't get too dry, because in setting this up, it was a little more time than what you see on camera to get things set up. I thought I kind of get ahead of myself. You know what? Six of one, half a dozen the other, I guess. Next time around, I'll just do the pre-shave on camera. It doesn't take that long. And look at how much lather I have. I have about 3 days worth of hair growth here. And I am really looking forward to taking it down. But look how much lather I have. And again, this is a milder, a little more refined citrus scent. It definitely is not citrus forward as I saw one reviewer describe it. I can't claim that phrase. I think it's a very good one. It's not mine. It belongs to another reviewer, but I think it describes it perfectly. Citrus forward. It is not citrus forward. So it's definitely going to be in the background. And that's what I'm getting from it, to be perfectly honest with you. Hang on a minute. Yeah, they're very, very subtle. Okay. Here we go. Boy, that is a nice, creamy, yogurty kind of lather. That is really, really terrific. Look at that. That's That's amazing. Isn't that wonderful? All right, here is my Supply SE right here. Single edge injector razor. We're going to go ahead and heat this up under some hot water. Blade is all set to go. That is the Nixtop technology right there, the thin guard right there. So we're going to heat this up under some hot water, and we will be ready to go here. Oh, yeah, that's got it. All right, here we go. 15 degrees, a light touch. Let the razor do all the work, gentlemen. Oh, yeah, this is definitely my go-to razor for a head shave. Love, love, love this razor for head shaves. Absolutely the best. I mean, I can just feel it go right through that hair. No problem. Very, very smooth. The lather has a wonderful, wonderful cushion to it. Just terrific. Really, really, just really, really nice. Cushion's very good, allowing me to fly blind, so to speak, when I do the back of my head there like that. I like the Supply razor because I can find that 15-degree angle very easily going front to back on the top of my head like that. And also, I can't remember. I think back to front is just as good, but we'll see. But right now, it's just doing a superlative job. Okay, let's make sure I do a little buffing here because of the slickness of this shave soap. This has some really, really nice glide. I can, right there like that. And the blade is always exposed because of the design of this razor. The lather just moves out of the way. But again, the slickness and the glide of this shave soap, of the lather from the shave soap, is really very, very good. My gosh, that's a great, great first pass. My goodness. My gosh. Love that. Love that. I got a little stand here for my Supply razor. I have it in chrome. I should have gotten it in black, but I'm thinking maybe, I've got a couple of other chrome razors, the 2.0 Supply razor, same handle, without the Nixtop technology. It's got a straight bar there, so that's why I got it in chrome, because those are in chrome. All right, let me just put a little bit of water on my head here. Just like that. Boy, that was a good pass. My gosh, that really took down a lot. And again, look how much lather I have here. Look at this. That's fantastic. So we're going to go ahead and just paint that on. Probably didn't need to add a little bit of, water, to be honest with you. But man, my gosh, this is just a marvelous lather. This 21st century soap paste is terrific. My gosh. Now, I happened to get this during the Ohio Wet Shavers meetup at River's Edge Cutlery in Columbus, Ohio. When was that? September 30th, I think? Yeah, that's when I got it. So I've had it ever since. It's just been waiting to use it for a review. And I decided to break it out for a head shave because of its wonderful slickness. The reviewers have said it just has some wonderful slickness, and I thought that would be perfect for a head shave. And it really is a very, very good choice for a head shave. We're going to go with pass number two. We're going to go back to front. Oh, yeah, that's fantastic. I just love this razor, how I'm always able to feel that blade engage. Boy, that's marvelous. That really is. And I think that first pass was just perfect. I mean, perfect in the sense that it really knocked down a lot of hair. Yeah, see, going back to front is fine too, although I think front to back with this razor, I get a little more control, which is why I'm going to switch. Again, I think it's a little easier to find the blade angle for me, front to back with this razor. Sometimes it's a little bit difficult to recall which approach is best for whatever razor I'm using, because I use several different razors for head shaves. So it's sometimes I just have to do it in order to recall what the best approach is. And yeah, when I do the top of my head, probably front to back is the best way to do that with the supply razor. I'm able to hit the angle a little more accurately. Works both ways. I just think for me, front to back works a little bit better. All right, so let's just put a little water up there and see where we're at. Boy, I tell you what, that was a great, that was a great two passes. We're going to take some lather here, and we're going to put it on my hand like this. And then we're going to go ahead and just move this around here and try to see if we missed any spots. And boy, this lather is just giving me a lot of great protection. My gosh, this is marvelous. Wow. Very, very good. Boy, what a great shave. I mean, I think I got very little touch-up required. I got everything. I really did. That's fabulous. Nope, I got everything. That's fantastic. Let me drain the sink. I've got a hot towel here that I'm going to use to do my warm water rinse, okay? Man, that's great. Wow. Fantastic. I can see a lot of hair in the sink here. I'm going to definitely have to clean the sink after this because there is a lot of stubble, hair stubble there. Boy, did I get a nice head shave. My gosh. And I really look forward to doing head shaves now. And again, we had a question recently on the Monday morning mailbag as to which razor is my go-to razor. And I mentioned that one of my razors, the supply razor, is my go-to razor for my head shaves. Now, I have a little bit of a blemish in the back, so I think I may have just glossed over that a little bit. But we'll see here. We'll see here. I did detect that before I did the shave. I should have let you know about that, but let me see where that is. Yeah, right back here. Okay, so I kind of picked that up a little bit. Usually, it's pretty good in going over that, but I was flying blind there, so I can kind of understand that. So, yeah, that's not too bad. I think that'll close up with the cold water rinse and also the alum block. So I'm not going to be too worried about that. But that's not the fault of the razor or the shave soap. That's just, you know, just the blemish that I did not feel because I'm not looking at it when I'm doing it in the back. I'm kind of flying blind. And normally, it's okay back there, but every once in a while, every once in a blue moon, I'll get a blemish there or something like that, and the blade will go over it and maybe just catch it a little bit. I think that's what happened here. But this is a cold rag right here. See where that is. I'm trying to find that. I can't really feel it. I can see it on the rag, but I can't really find it by touching here. It might be. Oh yeah, I think it's right over here, like this. Okay, yeah, that's where it is. It's right over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the alum block to that for a good 20 seconds to seal that up. So you'll see that when I do it. It's a really good method. And like I say, every once in a while, it's okay to, if you nick yourself a little bit for whatever reason, it gives me a good opportunity to show you that little bit of a trick that viewers have passed along to me. Okay, so here we go. Nice. Very, very nice. Okay. All right, so we're going to put that down. And here is my alum block. This is the solid alum block from Phoenix Shaving. We're going to run this under some cold water. And we're going to go ahead and see what kind of zinging and stinging we get. Okay, we're going to go over that. Oh, there it is right there. Okay, I can feel that. I can feel that zing right there. Yep, there it is. It's right over here. It's right back here. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to run that under some cold water, and we're going to hold that on there for about 20 seconds. Okay, 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005, 1006, 1007, 1008, 1009, 1010, 1011, 1012, 1013, 1014, 1015, 1016, 1017, 1018, 1019, 1020. And I think that's got it. Yeah. So, and then there's some water there. Here's the dry dock right here. Here's the alum block. We're going to put that in there like that. And I think this shave is just about done. Now, the question is, what do I want to use? Do I want to use limoncello or do I want to use Nordost? Both of these would be very, very good choices because even though this is orange and this is more lemon, both of them would go fine with this because, again, this is a mild scent in the Fine Accoutrements Italian Citrus right here. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to go with the limoncello because I think this has a little bit of a moisturizing quality to it. And I think it's probably, yeah, coming out milky. And I think this will give me a little bit of moisturizing there. And I think it even it might have some witch hazel in there too, which will do that nick back there some good. Oh yeah, this is perfect. Yeah. Yep, nothing on my hands, so that closed up nicely. So I think it was just a very, very small little micro nick that probably looked worse due to the fact that it's wet from the water on my scalp. Yeah. Boy, it's like, boy, what a nice, smooth head shave. My gosh. And yeah, I'm just kind of touching it here. Right here. Just touching it with my hand right here. Okay. And yeah, nothing there. Put that back there again. Yeah, that's all sealed up. No blood. So that was very, very small. Very, very slight. Again, looked worse than what it was. But also allowed me to show you that alum block trick that a lot of viewers have passed along to me. It works really, really well. Great, great head shave. Really, really terrific, terrific shave. So the Italian Citrus from Fine Accoutrements is very, very good. The soap base is very, very good. Beautiful lather. A lot of nice glide and cushion. Again, I think if I had been watching where I was, I would have been able to avoid it, but I didn't see it because I was flying blind. I think if it was something that it was a blemish that I saw on my face, and you've probably seen me do that, have that kind of shave on camera, I'm able just to modify my approach and my touch a little bit to kind of glide over it, not to aggravate it. Here, I didn't even know I was in the area of it. So, six and one, half a dozen the other. But I think it was very, very minute. And I think the glide and the cushion of the lather helped keep it from being far, far worse. Let me put it that way. I think it did because the alum block sealed it up very, very nicely. So this was a really, really nice evening head shave. I guess I could say no nicks, no cuts, no irritation. Let's just go back here one more time. Okay. Yeah, no blood, nothing there. No nicks, no cuts, no irritation. Really, really terrific, terrific shave. So check it out from Fine Accoutrements, Italian Citrus. It has a more subtle citrus kind of scent, and it is not citrus forward, so to speak. It is not overwhelmingly citrus, is what I mean to say. So it's not going to get in the way should you decide to use a different aftershave that is a little more bold in its citrus note, such as Ariana and Evans' Limoncello or Barrister & Mann's Nordost. Both of these will go fine as an aftershave to Fine Accoutrements Italian Citrus. I'm curious about their particular aftershave. I believe I saw somewhere in one of the reviews that the aftershave, the Italian Citrus aftershave, is a little more bold in its scent. So I'll have to acquire some of that to find out and confirm that. All right, that's it. Thanks very much for tuning in again. I really do appreciate it. Please share, please subscribe, please like, hit that bell so it'll give you a yell the next time I upload a video. Comment below. Let me know. Check out all the wonderful artists and soap makers and sellers that you see displayed on the bottom of the screen right now. They make and offer some wonderful artisan shave soap. They also offer some wonderful wet shaving gear to enhance your traditional wet shave. The next time you're online, please take a moment, pay them a visit. I sure would appreciate it. Thank you very much. Also, check out my Amazon product page at amazon.com/shop/MarkZerady, where you'll find all the Amazon listed products that I review in this channel, organized and categorized so you can find everything in a snap very easily. Thanks very much for tuning in again. I really do appreciate it. I'll see you again real soon.